Hi, welcome to the lesson. In this lesson, we are going to learn about how to draw free body diagrams. We are going to learn the drawing of FBD. Do you know what is FBD? To know that, first of all, we have to know about forces. A force causes an object to change its velocity by a change in speed or direction. Force is a vector quantity since direction is important. There are contact forces between objects that touch, and there are field forces between objects that do not touch. The SI unit of force is Newton. The formula for force is F equal to ma. The unit for mass is kilogram, and the unit for acceleration is meter per second square. So a kg meter per second square is the same as the Newton. And how many types of forces are there? And which symbol we are going to use in FBD? Let us understand. First one, gravitational force. Force of gravity that all objects on Earth experience. For this, we have to use W. In FBD. Next one, frictional force. Force exerted between surfaces as an object moves across it. For this purpose, we are going to use small f. Next one, normal force. Force exerted on an object when it is on top of another object. It always perpendicular to resting plane. And the symbol is N. Applied force. Force on an object being pushed or pulled. For this purpose, we are using capital F. Next one, tension. Force transmitted through a string or a rope or a cable or a wire. For this, we are going to use capital T. Next, air resistance. Force exerted on object as it travels through the air, usually negligible. For this purpose, we are going to use F air in free body diagrams. Then, what is free body diagram? FBDs are free body diagrams are used to show relative magnitude and direction of all the forces acting on an object in a given situation. Then, how to draw these FBDs? First of all, you have to draw the object as a box or a point. The larger the force, the longer the vector arrow should be. The direction of the arrow's tip should show the direction that the force is acting. Always label the force vectors. With constant velocity, vectors are equal. And with acceleration or deceleration, vectors are unequal. You have to remember these points to draw FBD. Now, let us going to see an example. A ball is at rest on the ground. Do you know what the forces are acting on it? First one, that should be gravitational force. And it is denoted by capital W, and it acts from the center of the ball. And next one is normal force. It always perpendicular to the plane, that is ground. Then look here, in FBD we can show these forces like this. This is the FBD of a ball at rest. We should remember that it is at rest means both the forces must be equal. That's why the length of the arrows should be equal. We have to show equal length arrows. Let us see another example. A skydiver jumps out of an airplane. Include air resistance. That means there is air resistance. The first force is gravitational force. That is W downwards. And another force is air resistance, that is F air. It acts upwards. So it should be shown like this in the FBD. Look here. Observe carefully. The length of the arrow of W is more than the length of F. Now we are going to see another example. Look here. We are going to see the FBD of a moving car. Here, how many forces are acting on it? First one is weight, that is W. It works from the center of the car. It is moving means there will be frictional force. It is shown by small f. And the normal forces are shown by N. And it is moving means external force is capital F. So these forces are acting on the car. In FBD we have to show like this. Look here, length of the arrow of capital F is more than the length of small f because it is moving. That means F is greater than small f. Now look at another example. A car is at rest on an inclined road like this. How many forces are acting on it? First force, that is W. It acts from the center of the car. And it is at rest means there will be frictional forces. And after that, normal forces acting at the wheels. So these forces can be shown in an FBD like this. Look here, inclined road and the box, the block represents the car, and weight arrow is shown here, and the normal force, it must be perpendicular to the plane. That's why we have to show like that. And next frictional force will be there, though that force is shown like this. Thank you.